going to go through the process of hot smoking both sea trout and salmon. Sea trout was always a very famous product from Ireland. Up until about 20 years ago, it was very easy to catch in the estuaries around Ireland, the Shannon region, down in the south of Ireland, up in Donegal. However, stocks have now diminished to the point where it is no longer sustainable to be using wild sea trout. For this reason, we will be using a organically farmed sea trout from Goatsbridge, and the process that we go through takes roughly 24 hours start to finish. We're going to start off with a sand, what I call a sand here, and this is a mixture of fennel seeds, dark brown sugar, Maldon sea salt, and ground juniper berries. The sea trout that we have, like I said, is organically farmed, and the first thing we do is we check for pin bones. This is pre-pin boned, so there shouldn't be many, but as you see, the machine that does pin bone them occasionally misses one, so we throw that away. We're going to remove the belly fat and a little bit of the dorsal fat. And actually, while I was doing that, I felt another pin bone. And having a proper pair of pin boning pliers handy is always good. From there, we take the sand over to an area that we've prepared over here. We're going to sprinkle some of the salt, sugar, and spices. And we're going to do this in batches of about 4 fillets. Next thing, this is what we call a brining process because of the amount of salt. And basically what this brining process does is it starts to literally cook the fish in salt. Get that ready, fits into a tray, like that. Put another tray on top of it. The best way of getting weight in the kitchen is to use a large pot and fill that with water. That will now be pressed and marinated in that salt and sugar mix for 4.5 hours. So the sea trout has now been in its sand, its pickling sand, for 4.5 hours, weighed down by as much water as we could get into the pot. We'll now take the pot off. Thanks, Gary. Good to go. So we will wash the sea trout to get most of the herbs off, but not all. Now go into a walk-in fridge overnight near the fans that will dry them. That will form a layer called a pellicate. So here we are the following day, back in the Abbey Court kitchens, another day, another dollar, and we are going to smoke the sea trout that we prepared yesterday. The sea trout, as you can probably notice, has now dried out significantly, and this is the formation of a pellicate, which is basically the salt, the sugar, and the herbs have denatured the proteins on the surface of the fish, and it's now ready for smoking. There's one last stage that we're going to do, and that is we're going to add seaweed to season it. We have to be a bit careful with this because the seaweed is quite salty. We're adding two different types of seaweed. We're adding a dried dillisk. Also going to add some very, very finely cut nori. Now, nori is the seaweed that goes onto your sushi. Ireland has enormous natural resources of seaweed. We have 1,200 miles of the Wild Atlantic Way, almost all of which contains seaweed. So we are one of the major exporters of seaweed in the world. And it's nice to use in cooking. One of the things that you'll notice in videos like this is the fact that we are working in a kitchen that is producing other food at the same time, so you may hear oven alarms going off and so on. So these are now ready to go into the smoker. What we need to do now, and I started doing this earlier, is we need to soak our wood chips, and we will just drain the water off. And put these into our smoker cartridge. The smoker cartridge then goes into our smoker. In the back of the smoker, we have a probe that gets extremely hot, red hot, and that ignites the wood and everything else. In this particular example, we are using hawthorn wood to smoke. We do have 10 or more different types of woods that we can smoke with, from plum wood, pear wood, mesquite, alder. We have quite a lot of different types of wood that we can smoke with. So now that we have the cartridge in there, we can load the sea trout. It's a fully loaded smoker. We will be smoking by time, but we will be cooking by temperature. So the probe will be used in the second part of this operation. Settings on the smoker. We want the lowest cooking temperature available, which is 71 degrees. We want a smoking time of 18 minutes. The internal temperature of the fish to reach 57 degrees, and the actual cooking temperature, or the holding temperature, we will take the 57. Cooking temperature, the lowest we can do is 71, which will be fine. And we hit the start button. So the sea trout has now been in the smoker for its 18 minutes smoke time, and then to come up to a temperature of 57 degrees, which took roughly 40 minutes on top of that. So it's a very gentle cook. And as you'll see now, take the spike out that registers the temperature. Trays, which will then go into the glass chill until the sea trout is fully cold. The sea trout is being used in a variety of dishes here at the hotel. have on the menu right now. This is a sea trout pate. It's the sea trout itself. It's served with a maple and beetroot cubes. It's served with a beetroot horseradish and candied fennel and some small pieces of samphire. And then at the very last minute, we grill some sourdough bread with a little bit of thyme butter on it, and that goes the warm bread next to the fish.